Welcome to day 21. We are in the final week of this being in the present moment meditation for 27 days. I had to find some really great inspiration for today's meditation. I just didn't feel that what I had planned was enough. And I found it. I found my inspiration. It said that we don't see God as He is. We see God as we are. We don't see God as He is. We see God as we are. Say it one more time. We don't see God as He is. We see God as we are. Man made God in his own image. Powerful. You know why that's so powerful? Because it's an ultimate teacher. Some people think that masters, teachers, God has to be this idea of super holy, the image that we create in our minds, the mental God. You know, he might be, well, he's got to have long hair, right? He's got to, maybe a beard, definitely a robe. You know, you'll never hear him talk about things like alcohol, drugs, sex, none of that. None of those things are true. No. See, the ultimate master has been through and knows about all of those things. He is what we call down to earth. Can't guide someone on a journey if you don't know the journey. They don't have people that lead safaris or lead trails through Peru or rainforests or Africa that haven't been on the trail before. That would be the blind leading the blind, right? So ultimately, in this lesson, in being in the present moment, you now have the power to experience life force itself, which is God. And I say that because that means that ultimately you are your most valuable teacher, being in this present moment. And that is why we see God as we are. You have the power within this present moment to work with life force itself, that divine presence, often referred to as God. And the only thing that you can be sure of in the present moment is that you're experiencing it. That's it. And that is you. That is the power of you and the now. And when you can bring yourself to this present moment where you're out of your head, you're not thinking out of your head. You don't think that you are your mind any longer because you're not your mind. When I say you are not your mind, if you can recognize that and you can feel this presence of being thinking through the mind, you will feel this ultimate divine presence inside and outside within the present moment. I can't really explain it any further than that. You'll feel it. You'll know what I'm talking about. When you move about your day today, in whatever meditation that you do, in whatever way that you remain mindful in the present moment, think about your view of yourself and how that relates to your view of God. Look around in the present moment at everything, feeling aware that you're not your mind, that you're experiencing this in this body, and that you are viewing everything as you are. And that alone is God. That is creation. That is divine love and light. And it is amazing, for lack of every possible describing word, in its truest form and in its truest essence. In this, I want to say thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity to have this present moment with you and to share it, because you've helped me to have this realization myself. And that's life-changing. That is so cool to be in that place. I hope that you can feel that as well, and that it is just as profound of a feeling and a moment for you. Lift up that view of yourself so as to raise the vibration of that divine force, that divine energy that we call God, that's really just a reflection of us and our internal struggles or the love that we have for ourselves. Thank you for being God, for being powerful, for being my teacher.